Regarding the second poster we also presented yesterday here at San Antonio, this was a systematic review and meta-analysis also conducted by our group at Jules Bordet, and that was led by Guilherme Nader Marta, who is a Brazilian medical oncologist, also a medical research fellow at Bordet. Where we aimed to assess the efficacy of anti-HER2 tyrosine kinase inhibitors in metastatic HER2-positive breast cancer with or without brain metastases. So basically, as you know, the brain metastasization is a huge clinical unmet need in breast in cancer in general, but also specifically in these two subtypes of breast cancer, which are triple negative and HER2 positive, and we know that up to 50% of patients with metastatic HER2-positive breast cancer can experience this condition. We also know that tyrosine kinase inhibitors have been shown activity in the central nervous system metastases in this particular setting. So basically we aimed to assess with the systematic review and meta-analysis the efficacy of anti-HER2 tyrosine kinase inhibitors in patients with and without brain mets and assess if there is a difference between these two subpopulations of metastatic HER2-positive breast cancer. So we did the systematic review, we searched the three main databases of PubMed, Embase, and Central, and we also searched for conference proceedings in ESMO Breast and San Antonio Breast Cancer Symposium for randomized clinical trials that compared TKI-containing regimens versus non-TKI-containing regimens in the treatment of metastatic HER2-positive breast cancer with brain mets at inclusion, including patients with brain mets at baseline. So we basically found five randomized clinical trials containing in the experimental arm tucatinib, lapatinib, pirotinib, and afatinib. And these trials included more than 2,400 patients in these five clinical randomized trials. And basically, in terms of progression-free survival, that was the primary endpoint of the analysis, we showed a non-statistically significant trend favoring the usage of TKI-containing regimens, both in patients with and or without brain mets. And when we did the sensitivity analysis, removing one by one of the studies, we found that when we remove LuxBreast trial, which is a trial that tested afatinib in this condition, which we know that have also some anti-HER2 activity, we showed that this difference, this trend favoring TKI-containing regimen becomes statistically significant, favoring the use of TKI-containing regimens in patients with brain metastases. The opposite trend we found in regarding overall survival. So in terms of overall survival, there was a trend, non-statistically significant trend favoring non-TKI containing regimens. And when we did a subgroup, the sensitivity analysis, removing HER2CLIMB trial, which is a trial containing tucatinib with trastuzumab and capecitabine in the experimental arm, and that we know that is one of the most active drugs in metastatic breast cancer, HER2 positive with brain metastases, the use of tucatinib, that it's also the only trial that included also patients with active brain metastases, which is something that makes it unique. When we remove this trial from the analysis, we see that this trend favoring non-TKI regimens in terms of OS becomes also statistically significant, favoring the non-TKI regimens in patients with brain metastases. So basically, this systematic review provided a comprehensive overview of the available anti-HER2 TKI regimens in this setting, and gave some hints on how to better select these patients according to the presence or not of brain metastases to specific specific anti-HER2 TKI regimens.